All right. So, this time I gotta. Before I do anything with open XR to VR stuff and codify that, I need to rework how I'm initializing or setting up the application. A lot of things are hard coded. I want to be able to set. So, right now, if I try to start the application without a VR environment, it crashes because I don't have the ability to turn off VR except hard coding it in. I want to start adding options to either via the command line when you open the application or through like a configuration file, set settings, you know, turning on and off Windows, turning on or off VR mode, and similar stuff to that. So that is of course going to require be putting all of this stuff into this branch for a moment. And going back to the mainline. I'm going to start by clearing everything out. Goodbye. Okay, what we got here? Descriptor pool and stuff. We want to do... we're going to have some global settings. It's going to be like one large-ish struct. It's going to have a bunch of things in it, like so this will be like everything that you need to start up the application. So, basic window. If we even want a window. We'll do something really small, like 128 and 128. By default, it's true. Yes, we want to. Non-specified. Max, thank you. Command line options. For the moment, we'll just focus on the command line options for the moment. Then we'll add like config file. parse. Parse command line options. Wonderful. Makes a bit more sense. Parse the command line options. Then we'll have... First is command line options. Then we'll do a config file after the command line. Actually, do we want to do that? We would want the command line options to override whatever's in a file. Okay, whatever. Parsing command line options, that's it. That's all I'm doing right now. I need something. Okay, there's got to be something that's pretty good at parsing command line options. Okay. Options. Okay. So it's what, a single header? Use include header only, one file if possible. Test usage. Okay. Okay, I'm liking the look of this from the start, so I'll work with this. Let me grab it. Okay, copy from the most recent release. Ten kilobytes. Oof. That's big. All right. Work with it for now. External. All right. Interface library. Basically, there's nothing to this. Okay. Topoi. Go back to our usage. If we can try to keep it, does it have to be like CLI slash CLI? I need to include it at the base level. Okay. Does it have to be for one for the entire? Okay, from now we'll just keep it here. Okay, this is not quite working out. It's not including that, why not? Wait, what the? Back up there. There we go. Okay. Window options app dot sorry. Width, height, let's see how this goes. Vsync. Add flag. Vsync. And then there's down here. There was a not no flag. Okay, this. True and false. Okay. Debug. Need that as well. Validation and debug logging are technically different.
buffering. Be a flag rather. Yeah, because I want to be able to override it here. Or rather, no, there should be no way to actually set this graphics validation through a config file. It should always be on the command line, maybe? Whatever. I'm thinking too far ahead. Buffering. Okay, we got all these, then we go. That's a peanut try catch. Maybe let's CLI 11 parse. It's in a try catch. Okay, what if we just use it straight up? Does it return anything? Does not. Okay. Can I avoid that? Something right up here near the top. Hmm.
Okay. This returns something, does it? Return, oh, okay. Okay, no, I do need to return an integer then, I guess. Neat. Okay. That died pretty fast. I'm assuming it died right here, basically. No. Option already. Oh. Interesting. Okay. There's no actual options being set, so. Okay. It's this one with an argument of $1,280, I guess. We'll see if that comes up with anything. Or rather, it really should be like, Ken, you win 32 max. Because what, okay, what's going to happen is, these are going to be options that are, never mind whatever I was going to say. Whatever I was going to say is stupid and garbage. So, let's try it again. These are maxed out. So we have the options. Okay, we do have argc, right? We have three. Yeah, it's not going to be very helpful. Okay. Okay, what about, is that like a, interesting. So it automatically does this, which is very nice.
I won't do XR yet. Trying to think of a, because I want to be able to have like multiple levels. I want to have like the engine, and I want to have the application layer on top of that. Or do I? Okay, I have things here. Oh, no, no, yeah. Yeah, okay. So what will happen? Let's say, okay, we need a kind of a like a general thing. So we sit here, grab these options, and we use these options further down the line, such as, oh, well, basically further out, I'm going to have to do that, won't I? So right now, the width and height are set here. Rather, it will be, options. That's actually interesting. I wonder if yep, neat. There's also a leak that I gotta figure out, I guess. Where's this memory leak coming from, anyways? Device environment, 179. I'm not properly deleting this. I gotta figure something out about this, don't I?
Okay, so that would fix that later. Okay, we'll have this, we'll put, stick this outside, CLI app right out here. Parser, then we don't need these guys. We're just like add engine command line options and stuff like that. Then afterwards, we'd have like another one that'd be like app settings. That would then add its own setting sets of stuff, and then we'd run engine dot whatever. This. Sorry, not this. CL parser. These we do the CL parser. This will all be kind of hidden in here, so it properly deletes itself before we get back out. This could also eventually be turned into a function, but the CL options stay around. Then presumably we'd add that. We'd add. This at this stage instead. There'll be we need like a, okay. There's also the option to get things but the from a settings file. Now, I already have a YAML parser, so I'm probably just going to reuse that. I mean, what's the size of this thing is basically nothing, right? It is almost a megabyte. Holy. Well, I'm also in debug mode. Let's say if we were in release mode. How big is this stuff? Go, go, go. Actually, no, don't go to everything. Just stop it. I don't want to care about this one. Still absolutely massive. Oh dear God. Why? Why? What do I have in here? Parsing? And a bunch of templates. Sorry, how is this that big? Oh, right. Instantiations for all these types. And a lot of text, I guess, to go along with it. Alright, well. Not much I can really do now, so I'll just use it until I come up with a better solution later. So that'd be another option we add to this. Okay. I'm guessing there's just it just doesn't accept that at all. It'll just take a string though, right? Actually, first of all, go back to debug. Okay, did I already forget how to do this? Add option, start. Oh, it's referenced already, isn't it? Yes, it is. Okay. Is that acceptable? Yeah, it is. Okay. Second one will be to we probably have to do something like we'd have to search for the config file through a bunch of search paths and then open it up. Then we'd have, I don't know. And then presumably the file. Okay. So for parse. So we don't actually put any of the YAML stuff in here. Rather, I'll put it in these subfiles instead. I guess. I don't really like it too much. Okay, I'm gonna get you a string, really. Okay. Does it include? Yeah, it does include YAML CPP, so I don't need to include it here. I'm surprised I don't actually have it here. Oh, actually, it makes sense. I was trying to avoid it. Okay. I don't even have a general node right now. I need to wrap this all in a giant try as well. Okay, yeah, I don't. This is something I have to really think hard on because I don't want to have exceptions in the final stuff. So I'm going to have to find something other than YAML in the end. Right? Probably something simpler like INI. But for the moment, No, I don't even need to do this, do I? I just need to, if. Subnode, a window node called width, and it's the data is p options window.width. Also need the option of do we even have a window? May not have a window if we're like, especially if we're testing on just like in the back buffer or something. So I gotta deal with that. Max frame buffering. Okay. Really? Okay. If there's no settings file, then there's no settings file. That's fine. But if there is a settings file and we fail to parse it, then there's a fatal error. Otherwise, what is what is the exception that they use for this? Is there no like quick startup? Come on, come on, come on, come on. Tutorial how to emit YAML, how to parse a document. E dot what?
Okay, let's say I had, it'll be in the YAML, YML. I don't know, this should absolutely fail. Unless it doesn't, in which case, congratulations. Me on being absolutely terrible. And we'll leave real fast. Gotta just jettison real fast. Gotta go fast. Nice. Legal map value. Okay, that's great. That's great. That's great. That's great. Window. We have a width of 1280. We have vsync turned on, I guess. Great, great. So right now we have the options. We have graphics, sorry, no, graphics window, true. Turn that to true, okay. That note doesn't exist, great. Okay, parse. I probably also want to emit. Oh, but if I was to emit, oh, I need to put it into. Okay. What if Okay. We need to be able to spit these things back out to a file. But I can't do it directly in here because, of course, I have two layers. I'd at the bottom here somewhere, I'd have... Before I destroy everything, before I shut down absolutely everything... Well, actually, outside of this area, it'd be like, I'm actually shutting down the application, so I want to, like...
then I say like, oh, I want to like emit that. Doesn't really matter at this point. If it fails, it fails. Not much I can really do at this point, except say it failed. We'll have engine options, just an empty one. We'll do a comparison. We're only writing if no, it's not going to work like that. We'll work like this for now. So the node name, such as have window. Default. The actual data. Height async. If any of these are true, then we want to write the node. Otherwise, we don't. That buffering. That's basically, I'm not going to even bother with the validation. Actually, I will. Why not? Okay, it's in there now. Once I'm done with all of that, I just have to emit setting so engine. Spit it out to a file. Expected catch. Yeah, you did, didn't you? Okay, yeah, I'm exiting way too early. This all the way down to here doesn't even matter. Don't care. Okay, let's run it. There it is. Okay, that was basically what I had in there. Vsync is not added. Did I forget Vsync? Interesting. Interesting. Okay. Okay, default options for window vsync is false. True and true. Vsync is false and true. So it's not the same. I do have this the right way. Default data to data. So vsync. Oh boy. Okay, I see what's going on. Whoops, diddly doodly. Okay. Bit of a logical failure there on my part. Hit X out on the first true or the first one that was written instead of waiting to go through all of them and then write it if needed. Okay, some options probably don't even want to. That's a very special option, isn't it? These are two, like, I just never want to be able to write out.
having a window. Yeah, probably not as well.
I think I'll keep it there for the moment. It's a basic enough kind of system for, okay, this is what? What kind of license is this? It looks like a BSD or MIT. See if I can figure that out from there. License. Three clause BSD. Okay. This, that, and that. 1 point. What was it? 191. So let's see how option parsing library. I'll also probably, on the README, yeah, I don't even say anything quite yet. So we've got that. We'll add, can ignore. Come on. Config file. It'll spit it back out to the same file. They are the same to start with, actually, but they can be different. So if you want to start the application and run it, and then you make a bunch of settings changes, then you save it as a different file. What's the option usually called? Emit. Public dash dash dump config. Okay. this file's kind of getting a bit 811 lines. I'm thinking, oh, it's getting a bit big there. I guess I'll start with this as a basic settings mechanism. Engine settings. They don't actually even do anything quite yet, do they? Crap. That would probably help a little bit at this point. So we have two sets of options. What we're going to do is going to look. Merge them, most probably. Or, actually. Okay, no, I can do this a little bit sillier, but what I can do, CL parser. And then we do it again. We use the CLI parser to get options. Engine options. And then we rerun it again. So we, first of all, we do this. We get the command line options to get the configuration, a file if it changes. Then we parse that. Then we get the engine config file stuff. All that stuff gets written. Then it gets overwritten again by the command line stuff. And that gives us our final thing. Then we stick these engine options all the way down here. Yeah. I mean, yeah, I'm redoing the same thing twice, but yeah, whatever. If the code's already there, I'm just recalling it second time, not the end of the universe. Okay, that means we only have one. We don't have to do any fancy stuff. And then that means at this point we want to determine options. So. I don't really know the size of anything. So what I'm going to do is 12, 80, and 720. Something like that. We'll just say engine options dot window dot width. Height, amazing. That then we're going to also have Vulkan setup is going to take in the engine options actually. Because it's got some things, engine settings. And this is where we go in and then we say, hey, you know, if we have this stuff, if we have validation, then we'll put it on. And same thing for debug logging. Actually, it's a bit of a weird one, isn't it? Engine settings. No window. Okay, I already have no window. If we don't have a window, then there's no point for the swap chain extension, is there? Swap chains are for windows, as far as I can recall. And probably same thing here. Okay, then we go down to, okay, where is VK this? If we have debug logging, then we do it. If we don't, we don't. Simple as that. And then we have one down here. We've enumerated the physical devices. If equals that, and no, if it's just less than we can use it. The physical device count, then we can just use it straight up. Instead. Okay. Are there any other options I'm just missing for the moment? They added. Have window width height. VSync I don't use yet. GPU max frame buffering don't use it. Validation debug logging. Okay, it's all there. We got it. This took way too long, an hour and a half. Alright. Okay, this is a weird one. Like, none of them can actually find the CLI header. I'm just looking at the Windows one. Right now, it's just not there. Even though, like, the file, like, I add the subdirectory CLI 11. I go in. CLI 11 is there. The interface is there. I've included it in here. Oh, I put it in the wrong one. Okay. Never mind. That is me being a dumbass. Fix that up. Go, 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 go. Okay, and that one got through fine, so let's see if I can that in, push that up, and we'll call it on that one. Cheers.